MV Struma was a small ship with a long history that included a number of changes of use and many changes of name. She was built in 1867 as a British Marquis's luxury steam yacht and ended 75 years later as a Greek and Bulgarian diesel ship for carrying livestock. She was launched as SS Xantha, but subsequently carried the names SS Sollust, SS Sea Maid, SS Cepheus, SS Esperos, Magdania and finally MV Struma. As Struma, she tried to take nearly 800 Jewish refugees from Romania to Palestine in December 1941. Turkey detained her in Istanbul because Britain refused to admit her passengers to Palestine. In February 1942, a Soviet submarine torpedoed and sank Struma in the Black Sea after Turkish authorities had towed her out to sea and cast her adrift. Building. Palmer's Shipbuilding and Iron Company of Jarrow in northeast England built her in 1867 as the iron-hulled yacht Xantha for Henry Paget, 2nd Marquess of Anglesey, who was a courtier to Queen Victoria and Lord Lieutenant of Anglesey in North Wales. She had a quadruple expansion steam engine built by Ernest Scott & Co. of Newcastle-upon-Tyne, and three schooner-rigged masts. Changes of owner and use. At some date an owner renamed her Sollust. In 1898 she was acquired by a J.L. Phipps, who renamed her Sea Maid. After 1902 Sea Maid's ownership is unclear. At some date she sailed to Greek waters, and one source suggests that in 1913 during the Balkan Wars the Kingdom of Greece requisitioned her as a troopship to take soldiers from Chalkidiki to Amphipolis. In 1916 a Greek shipping company, Thrakiki Atmoplia, acquired her, renamed her Cepheus and used her as a coastal trading vessel. At an unknown date she passed to another Greek owner, Georgios Mylonas, who renamed her Esperos and registered her in Thessaloniki. In 1932 Mylonas sold her to a Bulgarian owner, Dimitar Nenkov, who renamed her Magdania, based her in the port of Varna and used her to carry cattle on the river Danube. Lloyd's Register of Shipping does not list her as Makedonia, and she last appears as Esperos in the 1934 edition. If she was no longer ocean-going she may have been deregistered. One source claims Makedonia was not in service after 1937. In 1941 Nenkov sold her to Compagnia Mediterranea de Vapores Limitada, which was controlled by a Greek shipping agent, Jean D. Pandelis. He renamed her Struma and registered her under the Panamanian flag of convenience. At some date one of the ship's three masts had been removed. Lloyd's Register of Shipping lists her as still having her steam engine in 1934, but within a few years it had been replaced with a three-cylinder marine diesel engine built by Benz and CIE of Mannheim in Germany. Some sources claim that the diesel engine had been salvaged from a wreck sunk in the Danube, sinking. In 1941 the New Zionist Organization and the Beta Zionist Youth Movement chartered Struma from Jean Pandelis to take Jewish refugees from Romania to Palestine. On 12 December 1941 she left the port of Constanța in Romania carrying 10 crew and about 781 refugees. Her diesel engine was not working so a tug towed Struma out to sea. She drifted overnight while her crew tried in vain to start her engine. She transmitted distress signals and on 13 December the tug returned and the tug's crew repaired Struma's engine. Struma then got underway but by 15 December her engine had failed again and she was towed into Istanbul in Turkey. While Turkish mechanics made unsuccessful attempts to repair Struma's engine, there was a 10-week impasse between British diplomats and Turkish officials over the fate of the refugees. Because of Arab and Zionist unrest in Palestine, Britain was determined to minimize Jewish immigration to Palestine under the terms of the White Paper of 1939. Under pressure from Britain, Turkey denied the refugees permission to come ashore. One pregnant refugee who suffered a miscarriage was allowed to disembark and admitted to an Istanbul hospital. On 23 February, Turkish authorities boarded Struma. Her engine still did not work, so they towed her back out into the Black Sea and cast her adrift about 10 miles off Istanbul. On the morning of 24 February, the Soviet submarine SHCH-213 torpedoed her. Struma sank quickly and many people were trapped below decks and drowned. Many others aboard survived the sinking and clung to pieces of wreckage. But for hours no rescue came and all but one of them died from drowning or hypothermia. Struma's first officer clung to a piece of wreckage that was floating in the sea along with a 19-year-old refugee, David Stolia. The officer died overnight, but Turks in a rowing boat rescued Stolia the next day. The only survivor of about 791 people who were aboard. Memorials at Ashdod and Holon in Israel commemorate those who were killed by her sinking. Struma's wreck has not yet been found.